Good morning, and welcome to the 5th Annual Arts for Life Theater Mask Awards. I'm Melissa Boyer. I'm a TMA Steering Team Committee and Arts for Life Board Member.
And I'm Tim Naglin, TMA Steering Committee Member and AFL Board Member. We'll be your co-hosts for today's presentation. This year, of course, we're doing something a little bit different, and we hope you enjoy it.
We will also be doing something special for acceptance speeches this year. So if you win an award today, please stay tuned through the end of the presentation for information about how to do an acceptance speech and also how to pick up your physical award.
The Theater Mask Awards help celebrate excellence in theater in the St. Louis metro area. I've heard a lot of people talk about how much they miss theater, miss being with their friends, slipping on costumes, learning lines, and dare I say it, even missing tech rehearsal. Some people have found new and creative ways to keep theater alive in this area, from recording radio plays to creating original Zoom content or just making silly quarantine videos. This community has helped people stay connected to each other and to what we love. This is such a large community, an involved community, that theater will never go away. So let's celebrate theater and be excited about all of the performances yet to come. And there will be performances to come.
Let's get started with the award for Outstanding Juvenile Performance. The nominees are Anna Bowman, It's a Wonderful Life. Anna Drake, The Bad Seed. Natalie Hayes, It's a Wonderful Life. Annabelle Landis, It's a Wonderful Life. Declan Ryan, Over the Tavern. Talia Wright, The Miracle Worker. And Maywin Zarzak, It's a Wonderful Life. And the award goes to Anna Drake, The Bad Seed.
Our award for Outstanding Costume Design is sponsored by The Olive Tree in the Grove. The Olive Tree in the Grove is currently completing pre-production of the new musical, To the Moon, about the American space race, written by Landon Ashworth, who stars in Steve Carell's Netflix series, Space Force. More details coming soon. For Outstanding Costume Design of a Play, the nominees are Gene Heckman for A Soldier's Play, Laurie DeBord for The Bad Seed, Gene Heckman for Biloxi Blues, Lee Cox for Happily Ever After, Gene Heckman for Plaza Suite, and Liz Callahan for The Miracle Worker. And the award goes to Gene Heckman for Plaza Suite. Congratulations, Gene.
Our award for Outstanding Set Design is sponsored by Clayton Community Theater. Clayton Community Theater is in its 22nd year of producing high-quality, award-winning theater. Their motto is, Places Everyone. There is a place for anyone who wants to be part of the creation. The nominees for Outstanding Set Design of a Play are Chris Resinius, Don't Dress for Dinner. Christy Luster and Gary Wilson on Golden Pond. Brad Sanker, Peter and the Starcatcher. Chris Resinius and Justin M. Spurgeon, Plaza Suite. Glenn, Robin, and Shannon Niedmeyer, Rumors. Chris and Ellie Lanham, The Miracle Worker. the award goes to Chris and Ellie Lanham, the miracle worker.
For Outstanding Lighting Design of a Play, the nominees are Nathan Schrader for A Soldier's Play, Dennis Stevenson for A Twisted Christmas Carol, Shay Maples and Dennis Stevenson for And Then There Were None, Nathan Schrader for Biloxi Blues, Jason Kuntz and Andrew Senker for Peter and the Starcatcher, and Chase Coates for Plaza Suite. And the award goes to Nathan Schrader for A Soldier's Play. Congratulations, Nathan.
Groups we would like to recognize for their hard work. The first two are the Theater Mask Awards Steering Team Committee and its umbrella organization, Arts for Life. And also a big thanks to all of our judges who drove both near and far to see all of these fantastic productions.
On to our next group of awards. The award for Outstanding Supporting Actress in a Drama is sponsored by Act Two Theater. The mission of Act Two Theater is to provide a quality, entertaining, and affordable live theater experience to the residents of St. Charles County and the surrounding area. Our community commitment is to delight and captivate audiences with quality performances. For Outstanding Supporting Actress in a Drama, the nominees are Cammy Ryan for The Bad Seed, Sarah Polizzi for It's a Wonderful Life, Krista Wheatley for It's a Wonderful Life, Nori Rhodes for One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, Marissa Puller for The Father, and Susan Wiley for The Miracle Worker. And the award goes to Sarah Polizzi for It's a Wonderful Life. Congratulations, Sarah.
The nominees for Outstanding Supporting Actor in a Drama are Randy Manning, It's a Wonderful Life, Jason Blackburn, One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, Tyler Crandall, One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, Aaron Mermelstein, One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, Greg Savelle, One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, and Andrew Woodard, The Miracle Worker. And the award goes to Randy Manning, It's a Wonderful Life.
For Outstanding Supporting Actress in a Comedy, the nominees are Annie Valuska for Biloxi Blues, Laura Megan Devaney for Don't Dress for Dinner, Rebecca Lothridge for Don't Dress for Dinner, Diana Kay for The Glitter Girls. Pepe Partial for Over the Tavern. And Pam Boker for Peter and the Starcatcher. And the award goes to Pam Boker for Peter and the Starcatcher. Congratulations, Pam.
The nominees for Outstanding Supporting Actor in a Comedy are Sam Guillemette, Biloxi Blues. Jack Lehman, Biloxi Blues. Greg Savelle, Biloxi Blues. Jeremy Schnelt, Biloxi Blues. John Emery, Don't Dress for Dinner. And Jimmy Wall, Over the Tavern. And the award goes to Sam Guillemette, Biloxi Blues.
This year, the Theater Mask Awards are recognizing two groups for special achievement in theater. Alton Little Theater's Vintage Voices and Hawthorne Players' Voices of Valhalla have been a significant and creative addition to the theater scene in the St. Louis metro area.
For 18 years, Vintage Voices has paid tribute to the citizens of the Riverbend who were laid to rest in the beautiful and historic city cemetery. But their voices, while alive, became the lessons for further generations. So each October, we listen anew to the words that enlighten and inspire us to study history, be entertained, and be better for the walk through the leaves and paths of our ancestors. Accepting for Alton Little Theater is Lee Cox.
Good day. I am Celia and French Lovejoy. And I stand here today at the final resting place of my husband, Elijah Parrish Lovejoy. It is a solemn ground, and yet it fills me with renewed sadness. Had we time, I would share the story of our marriage and our time here in Alton, and I would ask you to contemplate what saying "I love you" really means in this life. But today is for another matter. Today, I am filled with gratitude for you for honoring our voices, the visionaries, the pioneers, the good men and women who created a life in this little river town where the great river bends to meet the Illinois prairie. The industrious people who now rest in this cemetery had voices of hope and courage and inspiration. They loved the lessons of history, and they mirrored the theatrics of an emerging America. You know, our spirits never die, and our souls find peace when good people like you come and listen to the lessons of the past and create their own stories of honor and find their voices. We are so grateful for this acknowledgement. 18 years of hard work and 88 actors share in this celebration of innovation. It is a very good day indeed.
Hawthorne Players and Valhalla Cemetery began presenting Voices of Valhalla, Hayrides Through Time, at Valhalla Cemetery in 2010. The unusual productions feature nighttime hayrides through the cemetery, with stops along the way, where actors portray some of the permanent residents who tell stories about their lives and times. For those who prefer to see theater in a hay-free environment, there are also two indoor performances in Valhalla's historic mausoleum. Accepting for Hawthorne Players is Larry Marsh.
On behalf of Hawthorne Players and Valhalla Cemetery, I would like to extend our sincere thanks to Arts for Life for this special recognition. Greetings from Valhalla. This place is home for an eclectic group of residents, rich and poor, persons of many faiths or no faith at all. There are a few celebrities on the grounds, but most of the stories told in Voices of Valhalla are about ordinary people, often doing extraordinary things. Some of the presentations are funny, some disturbing, some inspiring, but all of them are based on the lives of real people. And during the evening, audiences learn more about St. Louis area history and times. Over the past 10 years, I've been blessed with a remarkable group of talented and courageous actors. They wait there in the dark for the next wagon to appear, sometimes enduring cold, windy, and damp fall weather, occasionally joined on the grounds by owls, coyotes, or the unknown. The actors must love the challenge. They keep coming back for more. Tim Callahan, for example, has been out there in the dark every year. Heroes and villains, scouts and scoundrels, mayors and moguls, saints and sinners, the shamed and the shameless, they're all there in your local cemeteries, their stories waiting to be told. Maybe you can join them in Valhalla, only for a visit, of course. Good day.
Our next group of awards starts with Outstanding Leading Actor in a Drama. For Outstanding Leading Actor in a Drama, the nominees are Jonathan Garland for A Soldier's Play, Dennis Jethro II for A Soldier's Play, Don McClendon for A Soldier's Play, Lavelle Thompson Jr. for A Soldier's Play, Matthew Lennart for One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, and Louis Lefikas for The Father. And the award goes to Matthew Lennart for One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. Congratulations, Matthew.
The nominees for Outstanding Leading Actress in a Drama are Susan Wiley, The Bad Seed; Anna Valeska, Dial M for Murder; Brittany Henry, Eurydice; Betsy Gassock, One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest; and Kaylee Ryan, The Miracle Worker. And the award goes to Kaylee Ryan, The Miracle Worker.
For Outstanding Leading Actor in a Comedy, the nominees are Patrick Blanner for Biloxi Blues, Michael Bouchard for Biloxi Blues, Jeff Struckoff for Biloxi Blues, Austin Brock for Is He Dead, Matt Dawson for Is He Dead, and Dylan Comer for Peter and the Starcatcher. And the award goes to Michael Bouchard for Biloxi Blues. Congratulations, Michael.
nominees for Outstanding Leading Actress in a Comedy are Kim Hillman, A Twisted Christmas Carol, Tracy Murphy, Over the Tavern, Nancy Leibovitz, Plaza Suite, Amanda McMichael, Plaza Suite, Pam Boker, Rumors, Danielle Feinstein, The Musical Comedy Murders of 1940. And the award goes to Amanda McMichael, Plaza Suite.
Today, we honor the memories we have made with those we have lost in the past year.
Our final group of awards starts with Outstanding Small Ensemble. And the nominees are Alton Little Theater, A Twisted Christmas Carol. The Theater Guild of Webster Groves, Dial M for Murder. Act 2 Theater, Don't Dress for Dinner. O'Fallon Theater Works, God of Carnage. Alton Little Theater, On Golden Pond. Riverbend Theater, The Father. And the award goes to Alton Little Theater, A Twisted Christmas Carol.
For Outstanding Large Ensemble of a Play, the nominees are Clayton Community Theater for A Soldier's Play, Clayton Community Theater for Biloxi Blues, the Theater Guild of Webster Groves for One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, Act 2 Theater for Plaza Suite, Looking Glass Playhouse for Rumors, and the Theater Guild of Webster Groves for the musical comedy Murders of 1940. And the award goes to Clayton Community Theater for Biloxi Blues. Congratulations.
The nominees for Outstanding Direction of a Drama are Nada Vaughn, A Soldier's Play, Brant McCants, And Then There Were None, Gary Wilson, On Golden Pond, Jessica Kelly, One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, Jay Harvey, The Father, and Chris and Carol Lanham, The Miracle Worker. And the award goes to Nada Vaughn, A Soldier's Play.
For Outstanding Direction of a Comedy, the nominees are Sam Hack for Biloxi Blues, Paul James for Don't Dress for Dinner, Debbie Love for Over the Tavern, Justin M. Spurgeon for Plaza Suite, Glenn Nettemeyer for Rumors, and Becca Harbison for the musical comedy Murders of 1940. And the award goes to Sam Hack for Biloxi Blues. Congratulations, Sam.
The nominees for Outstanding Production of a Drama are Clayton Community Theater, A Soldier's Play, Alton Little Theater, And Then There Were None, the Theater Guild of Webster Groves, The Bad Seed, Alton Little Theater, On Golden Pond, the Theater Guild of Webster Groves, One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, and Riverbend Theater, The Father. And the award goes to Clayton Community Theater, A Soldier's Play.
For Outstanding Production of a Comedy, the nominees are Alton Little Theater for A Twisted Christmas Carol, Clayton Community Theater for Biloxi Blues, Act 2 Theater for Don't Dress for Dinner, Act 2 Theater for Plaza Suite, Looking Glass Playhouse for Rumors, and the Theater Guild of Webster Groves for the musical comedy Murders of 1940. And the award goes to Clayton Community Theater for Biloxi Blues. Congratulations.
Congratulations to all the nominees and award winners for your hard work put into your productions. Check back with the Arts for Life website for information regarding next year's ceremony.
For those of you who have won an award today, please stick around to receive information on acceptance speeches and trophy pickup after our advertiser thank you video. Yeah.
Congratulations on winning an award today. Trophies will be handed out at Clayton Community Theater on Sunday, July 19th from 1 to 3 p.m. That is tomorrow. You may pick them up yourself, send someone in your place, or coordinate with your theater company on how to pick up your award. If you cannot make it during that time or send someone, please contact Glenn Guillermo at gginstl@gmail.com.
For those of you who would like to record an acceptance speech, you may put together a 30-second video and send it to tmacelebrationvideo@gmail.com by July 25th. Please include your name and the award you've won in your email. This is not a requirement of you. You don't have to do this, but we thought it would be nice to be able to share your thanks to the community if you so chose. All acceptance speech videos will be posted on the Arts for Life STL YouTube page by July 31st. If you have any questions, you can email them to tmacelebrationvideo@gmail.com. Again, congratulations!